of information about business mastery. Would you agree?
Yes.
Today, I'm going to talk to you about personal mastery. I'm going to talk about you. How does that sound? Are you ready for that?
Yes.
Fabulous. So I want to kick off by asking you a question. Chris? Okay, no problem. Now, I have heard that Mercury retrograde finishes tomorrow. So, I'm hoping that everything's going to go smoothly, microphone and slides, and we're back up. Thank you very much, Chris. In fact, round of applause for the guys at the back who have been working so hard . Okay, let me ask you a question. Where in your life are you playing small? You see, over the last few days, I've been watching and I've been listening on a very deep level. I know that in some areas of your life, you play big. You feel confident, you feel focused, you feel full of energy and excitement in those areas. Would you agree?
Yes.
Absolutely. People look at you and admire you in those areas that you play big. But I also know that there are some areas in your life where you play small. Where you feel anxiety, where you doubt yourself, and where you hold yourself back. Do you know what those areas are? Over the next 60 minutes, I'm going to be sharing with you the four powers that will enable you to step up and play big. I want you to play big in all areas of your life. Because when you do, that is when you make a difference. And we're all here to make a difference, right? Yeah? To carry out a mission that you were brought here to fulfill. Share something with you in just a moment. And I think it's really going to make you think quite a lot, actually, in terms of what you're doing now and what you want to be doing in the future. But the question is, are you ready to reignite that fire in your belly?
Yes!
Great answer. Are you ready to live your life more consciously? Okay, so I want to share something with you. I read recently that we live 5% of our daily life through our conscious mind. That was like a little aeroplane. Thank you for that. Felt right at home. Yes, we live 5% of our daily life through our conscious mind. In fact, neuroscientists have shown that that 5% is actually 4. Now, how can I say this in a diplomatic way? The more aware amongst us, the more aware amongst us. In fact, the majority of people are operating at just 1% of consciousness. 1% of consciousness. The other 95 to 99%, we live through our subconscious mind. Now, the subconscious mind is one that's made up of all those programmed behaviours that we've acquired before you reach the age of 6 years old. Think about that for a moment. 6 years old? That's quite scary, isn't it? Yes, yes, yes.
Yes.
Just checking you're still awake after lunch. It's all good. Now, I want to imagine that everyone in this room is operating at just 1% of consciousness. Because I know some of you are looking around going, well, are you 5% or are you 1%? Right? So we're all operating at 1% of consciousness. I want you to think for a moment. What impact is that having on your life? Take a moment and think about that. What impact is that having? Shout a few things out.
Financial.
Financial, fabulous. Anybody else agree with that one?
Yes.
Yeah, any others? Closed-minded, that's a good one. Relationships, I heard.
Fearful.
Fearful, great one. Minimizing our joy, brilliant consciousness. 1% of consciousness. That's what we're operating at. The majority of people are operating at.
So, four powers that are really going to transform your life. And I'm going to step through each of those for you in turn. Want to know what they are? Yes! Love it. The first one is healthy living. The second is the way that you think. The third is your spiritual growth. And the fourth is leading your life. Now, before I take you through each one of these, I want to take you through a quick quiz to see what gaps you have. Who's up for that? Just one person? Woohoo! That's better. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you a number of questions. And what I want you to do is to have a think, and from your gut reaction, where do you have to say no? I want you to write down the areas that you have to say no to these questions. Clear? Fabulous. So the first power is healthy living. Do you eat healthy, nourishing foods? Now, some of you are going to be like, well, always, just like down the front. Your gut reaction, the majority of the time, do you eat healthy, nourishing foods? The second one is, do you actively reduce stress? Do you have strategies that you put in place to reduce stress? And the third is, do you have good work-life balance? It's funny, I just looked around the room and everybody's going, yes, no, except for one person who went like this. I'm not going to name and shame. Okay, so the second power is the way that you think. Do your mindset, your beliefs, and your thinking propel you forwards? They do now. Great answer. The third is your spiritual growth. Do you have a sense of awareness of who you are and why you are here? Do you actively look after yourself? Do you center and ground yourself? And are you present in your life? Ooh, less yeses there. That was interesting. Okay, and the fourth power is leading your life. Do you actively lead your life? Do you have a vision for what you want to achieve? And do you regularly set yourself goals and targets and work towards achieving them? There was a resounding no in the audience then. I don't know if you heard that. Yay! Okay, I want the people who said yes to every single question there to stand up. Woo! Come on, if you've said yes to all of those, stand up. Virtual high five to all of you. And I want you to meet me at the back at the end. It'd be great to have a chat. Now, I want to see how many of you didn't answer yes to any of those. Anybody? Okay, that is good. So that means that the majority of people in this room are on the way to stepping up and playing a bigger game, stepping into their power and elevating themselves. Congratulate yourselves right there. Now, the quiz that I just talked you through is actually a small version of a much fuller quiz. If anybody would like to take that fuller quiz, you have a sheet of paper on your tables. Looks like this. If you do want to take the full quiz, complete this form. Has any tables not got any? Can we send some down to the front just here for me? Thank you. So fill in those forms. And what I'm going to do is around halfway through, we're going to collect those back up. And I'm going to do a draw towards the end of the session. And the draw is to win 60 minutes with me over the next few days. Okay, how does that sound? Yay! If you're not excited, I am. Okay, so now I want you to have a think for a moment. Those areas where you had to say no, We're going to cue some music up in just a moment. I want you to take a moment and have a think. What gaps do you have in those four areas? Four areas are back up on the screen here for you to remind yourselves. So if we can cue some music, and I want you to have a think and make a note for yourself what gaps you have. And now I want you to turn to the person sat next to you. I want you to tell them which one of these four areas is holding you back the most. Ready? Go. Okay, and swap over. Fabulous. If I can bring you back to the front. Now, as we go through the rest of the session, I want you to hold in your mind the one area that you've just identified. We're going to step through each of the four areas now. So tell me, who wants to play big? Woo! Come on, a little bit more noise. Woo! That's better, that's better. That's the teacher in me coming out, apologies. Okay, so the first area is healthy living. The first power, healthy living. If you want to play big, get yourself in the best physical, mental, and spiritual shape that you can be in. Would you agree? Absolutely. Now, there are three key areas to focus on here. The first is healthy eating. The second is stress management. And the third is work-life balance. Work-life balance. Sorry, that might have been my accent there. Now, I want to address your concerns, because I know that a few of you in the audience will have concerns right now. You'll be looking at me and thinking, come on, Gina, what can you possibly tell us about healthy living? Am I right? That thought going through your head, anybody? I'm sure it is, I'm sure it is. I want to show you a picture. The person on the left is me. Thank you. Now, sometimes you can't tell with the picture, so guess what I brought? My pants. I like that. Scary, huh? Who wants them? I don't want them. Thank you. So as you can see from here, I used to be a UK size 16, which is a US size 12. Okay? Now currently, I'm a UK size 6, which is a US size 2. So that is the difference that we're talking about. Thank you. Everything that I'm going to share with you forms part of that journey. I'm going to give you strategies and ideas to help you to get an idea of where this has all come from and what you can do to make some really simple changes straight away. So this is me on the left-hand side. I was 22 years old, and as you can see, I was a lot bigger than I am now. It was quite interesting how it all came about. I didn't actually realize that I was as big as I was there. I had a sort of awakening in a changing room one day, and I just suddenly thought, wow, is this really me? Has anybody ever experienced that? Yeah? Yeah, and it was really quite shocking. It almost kind of smacked me in the face, and I was like, wow, okay, need to do something about this here. So guess what I did? No. Went on a diet, exactly. How many of you in the room have been on a diet? Okay, so you all know how this story ends. Absolutely. I did the whole dieting thing, it didn't work. And it was when I was diagnosed with IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. You all heard of that? Okay, I was diagnosed with that when I was 26 years old. And that was the real kind of kick in the teeth that I needed to make some really big changes in my life. I was diagnosed, the doctors told me I'd need to go on medication, and I'm just one of these people that said, no, I can deal with this myself. I don't need any sort of medication. I got myself into this, I can get myself out of it. So that's what I did. I learned as much as I could to get me to the point where I really wanted to manage those symptoms because it really wasn't pleasant. Now, I've totally surpassed that. I don't have any symptoms anymore. I'm totally healthy, have no effects at all. And a byproduct is I released all the weight that I was holding on to. Thank you. Thank you. I work with a lot of clients on body mastery, because that's clearly what I did. I mastered how to take control of my body. And one of the key things that I'm asked in terms of the body is around energy. How many of you struggle with energy levels? So you might have that peak and trough and peak and trough. You're craving all those sugary foods, yes? What time is it? In fact, you'll be craving them in around about half an hour, I would expect. I have this down now. The key question is, how do I sustain my energy throughout the day? And that's what I want to share with you today. So take a look at this. This is the insulin roller coaster. Anybody heard of the insulin roller coaster? Yeah. Fabulous. I'm sure you've all experienced it, even though you may not have heard of it. I want to talk through this with you right now. When you eat food, now I'm not going into too much science here, so relax. When you eat food, your body digests the food and turns it into a sugar, an energy that you can use to get you through your day-to-day activities. Now, when you put too much sugar or too much glucose in your body, what happens is it triggers the hormone insulin. You all heard of insulin? Okay. So the job of insulin, or one of the jobs of insulin, is to get rid of as much of that glucose that's circulating, that's over excessive within the bloodstream, and it puts it in the liver and the muscles so it can pull it out at a later date to use it whenever you need it again. Now, if there's any extra that is, so let's say your liver and your muscles are overfilled, then it goes into your fat stores, and that's really not good. How many of you know how difficult it is to get the fat out of your fat stores? Yeah. But we all know how easy it is to put in there, right? Absolutely. So the blue line on this graph is the insulin threshold. So that is the point where insulin is triggered. The red line is typical of a unhealthy diet. Mm-hmm. And you know it. So as you look at that red line, you can see that it undulates throughout the day. Now that shows what your energy is doing throughout the day as well. So you eat something in the morning, you get a big spike of energy, and then you drop. Usually around half 10, 11-ish, yeah? Everybody get that, half 10, 11-ish? There's a pattern here, trust me. Then you think, okay, I need something sugary, I need something to pick myself up. So you might have a cup of coffee or a biscuit, or some people have cigarettes to try and pull it back up. So you get that peak again. Lunchtime, you eat, then you get the trough. Around 3:30, that's when you start to crave those sugary things once again. Everybody familiar with that pattern at some point in their life? Yes, okay. Now, the green line is typical of a healthy diet. Now, can you see there how it doesn't go over the blue line at all? Yeah? So it undulates quite evenly throughout the day. Now, you see the bit where the red line goes over the blue line? That is the point where fat is put into your fat stores. You don't want that. That's really not good. Okay? So as you look at that and as you think about your life and you think, okay, you know, maybe I'm having a few peaks or troughs in energy, there are a few things to think about, and I'm going to give you those to you now. There's two main things to get you out of that cycle of unhealthy energy levels, if you like. The first one is to eat regularly. We've all heard about eating little and often, right? I always try to eat every 2 to 3 hours. Now, some people go, wow, that often. But yes, seriously, that often. And it doesn't have to be anything major, it can just be little snacks throughout the day. But if you eat every 2 to 3 hours, I can guarantee that you'll experience that green line. And the second big thing is to stay away from the core five. I call them the core five. Do you want to know what they are? Of course you do. So the first one is sugar. Now, as I'm looking around the room, I'm looking at who goes, oh. So make it known, right, the first one is sugar. The second is simple carbohydrates. The third is caffeine. That's usually the one where everybody goes, no. The fourth is stress. Stress. And the fifth is smoking. Smoking. So they are the core five. If you aim to stay away from those core five, you will eliminate much of that red line and you'll put yourself on the green line, which is where you want to be. Make sense? Getting in control of your body is fundamental if you want to achieve everything that you want in your life, to step up and play big. Make it your priority to get in the best physical, mental and spiritual shape that you can get into. The second power is the way that you think. You create your own reality with your thoughts. Every thought that you have ever had has brought you to today. If you don't like your reality today, it's time to clean up those thoughts. So how do you do that? How do you clean up your thoughts? It all starts with raising your awareness. Make it your priority to focus on the quality of your mind. Spend time doing some inner work to reprogram those beliefs and those thoughts that you had from childhood. You know those ones we talked about earlier? Spend the time doing that. And I'm going to get you kick-started on this journey today by asking you some really powerful questions. So I'm going to put some questions up on the screen in a moment. And if we can cue some music up, that would be fabulous. I'm going to give you about a minute for each question. And what I want you to do is note down your initial thoughts, your gut reactions to these questions. You ready? Everybody got pen and paper? Fabulous. So if we can cue some music. The first question is, what are you afraid of? Next question. A minute goes really fast, by the way, when you're in thought. Second question, where are you running away in your life? Next question. What doesn't serve you anymore? And next question. What is out of control in your life? Do you have to playing big? What do you believe about stepping up? What are the toxic thoughts that you keep thinking? What thoughts do you have that hold you back? And last question, what thoughts do you have that propel you forwards? Congratulate you for just doing that. It's not easy to think about some of those things, is it? I could tell from the whole energy kind of just went whew. In fact, a bit like that insulin roller coaster. Can you feel it? So let's pick it back up. I want you to be aware, though, that your thoughts have the ability to both hold you back and propel you forwards. Can you see that? You can make that conscious choice. So which choice are you going to make? Forwards, exactly. You want to accelerate yourself forwards to achieve those things that you want to achieve. Now, I always get my clients to think about those kind of questions quite early on in a program. The reason that I do that is because your self-belief can hold you back like you wouldn't believe. Would you agree? So to become aware of a few of those things that you've just wrote down in front of you is hugely powerful, and you can use that going forwards. So I hope that was beneficial for you to step through those questions. Now I want to take you to the Wizard of Oz. You've all seen it, right? Everybody's seen the Wizard of Oz. Just like Dwayne, I watched the recording as research quite a few times, and I loved every single plane of it. But there was one particular moment that really stuck in my mind, especially as we're talking about courage today. Let me introduce you to the Great Wizard. We all know the Great Wizard, right? Now, the wizard turns to the lion, and he says, "Courage is the victim of disorganized thinking." I just love that concept, disorganized thinking. You see, your thoughts are hugely powerful. They will shape your life. If you want to play big, clean up your thinking and become the best thinker that you can be. We're going to step on to the third power. Who remembers what it is? Can't hear you. Thank you. I think I'm going a little bit deaf in my old age, actually. I am older than I look, by the way. So your spiritual growth. Now, I need to say something right here. I'm not talking about religion. I'm talking about those life-changing practices to look after and prioritize yourselves. I'm talking about raising your consciousness, because when you do, life will flow, decisions will be so easy, and you'll have all the energy directed in the right places. That's what I'm talking about here. Now, there are many different spiritual practices we could talk about today, but the one that I really want to talk about is your mission. Become clear about your mission, your purpose, your vision, and what it is that you want. How many of you are clear about that right now? Okay, look around the room. How many of you want to be clear about those things? Absolutely. So your mission, get clear about what it is. Your purpose, what it is that you want. Identify what those things are. And then when you've done that, draw it out, write it down, or however you are creative, get that, what it is that you want, down somewhere on paper. And look at it every single day. Why do you think we look at it every single day? Reinforce it. Create the universal energy, absolutely. We want to stimulate the law of attraction. We've all heard of the law of attraction, I'm assuming, in the room? Yes, 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 I thought that was the case. So we want to stimulate that law of attraction. And there's three key elements to stimulating the law of attraction. The first one is to ask. Put it out there, get it out into the universe. Ask for what it is that you want. How many of you do that regularly? Okay, fabulous. How many of you are going to do that regularly? Absolutely. Draw it out, get it on paper, look at it every single day. Ask for those things that you want. The second part is to believe. Okay, so those people who have got it down on paper, how many of you actually believe that you can achieve all those things? Okay, I think a few hands went down there. Actually, that's interesting. So the second thing is believe. 100% believe that you can do all those things. So we are in control of the first two elements, ask and believe. The third element, we put it out into the universe. The universe will bring those things that you want. Now, I know that some of you in the room are going to be thinking right now, well, hang on a minute, Gina. I put something out 3 years ago, and it's still not happened. Anybody thinking that? You can be honest. I know, I've thought that in the past, certainly. Now, there could be, well, there are many different reasons why that is the case. And the main one is that you're not quite ready for it yet. So what happens when we're not ready for something? It doesn't show up. But what does show up instead are many different opportunities, people, situations that will get you one step closer to it. Have you experienced that in the past? Yeah, you may need to clear some energy. You may need to clear some space. You may need to develop, grow, learn something. And those opportunities are presented to us, even though you might not realize it, they're there to help you to achieve what it is that you want. Make sense? Absolutely. So get clear about what your mission is. And then follow the yellow brick road. So what do I mean by that? Go for it. Follow your intuition. I always think of the yellow brick road as your intuition. We're always being guided in the right direction. Whether you choose to hear that guidance or not, it is there. It's interesting, as children follow their guidance really quite simply, easily. They just do it. Would you agree? But as we become adults, we kind of lose touch with that connection a little bit. Now, one of the key things that I do quite regularly is I go out for a walk. I get myself out into nature, and I go for a walk. And that is the time that my best ideas come. That's when I know that I'm being guided and directed in the right way. And what I tend to do is take a little notebook with me. Yes, this is the actual one. No, I'm not going to open it because you'll see all my scribblings. Take a little notebook with you, because what you'll find is when you go on those walks, you'll have little thoughts that come in, and sometimes you'll think, whoa, where did that come from? And other times you think, yeah, I've thought that before, and you'll probably just discount those thoughts. Anybody ever done that? Absolutely. I regularly used to do that, so now I always take a notebook with me, and I write down all those little things that come into my head, however crazy they may seem, and trust me, there are some crazy thoughts that come in. But then when I get back, I take that notebook out and I have a look at it. And often when I'm sat there and thinking, right, what shall I do? I'll just open my notebook and the answer is there. I was guided a couple of hours earlier. And those things, I add them to my to-do list. You know, when I'm writing down the things that I'm going to do in the day, I add those elements into it because I know that that guidance is taking me to where I want to be. So follow the yellow brick road, follow your intuition. Look around you right now. What do you see? Beautiful women everywhere. And men, and a few men. Apologies. A few very beautiful men in the room too. Make sure that you're surrounding yourself with like-minded people. I know when you get back out there into the real world, there are many people that will try to knock you off track. Yes? These people right here, they're all on a similar journey to you. Connect with them. Speak to them. Don't leave here without hooking up with people and saying, do you want to go for dinner? Do you want to go for coffee? These people are your support network. So get connecting. By adopting those life-changing practices, and there are many practices that you can adopt, you'll be focused and you'll be clear on your direction. And very quickly, you're going to step up and play a much bigger game. Who wants some of that? Try that again. Who wants some of that? That's better. Yes, yes, yes. Woo! Who was that? High five. Right, the fourth power is leading your life. Leading your life is about being in control. It's about being clear upon what it is that you want, knowing your direction, and making sure that you put into practice all those milestones, you're setting yourself goals, and you work regularly to achieve them. How many of you do that, out of interest? Okay. Those that don't, honestly, it totally rocks your world when you do this stuff. Now, I've been studying people for the last, let's see, probably 11 years. And very early on, I realized that all successful people have a number of things in common. And I want to share one of those things with you today. Want to hear it?
Yeah.
Of course you do. This is so cool. The great leaders of today, they all have an early morning ritual that they do without fail every single day. Now, I'm talking Saturday and Sunday too. Okay? An early morning ritual that they do without fail. And why do they do this? They do it because it fires up their body, their mind, and their spirit before the day even begins. It sets the tone for the rest of the day. Absolutely. How many of you have an early morning ritual? Okay, we're going to explore this a little bit. This is fabulous. I want you to think about what your mornings look like. I want you to write down for me now what the first 2 hours of your day look like. What activities are you doing in those 2 hours? Can you do that in a minute? Fabulous. I want you to take a look at what your mornings look like. Do you take time out to get yourself in a great frame of mind so you can step into your day the way you want your day to play out? How does that look? Does it look good? Show of hands, how many does it look good? How many need work on it? Okay, keep those hands up a minute. Let me just have a quick look. All right, great. So I'm going to give you a couple of ideas now on a ritual. Now, I did say an early morning ritual. So this is something that people do before they even start their workday. So it might involve getting up a little bit earlier. Be prepared for that. And if you're not prepared for it, maybe go half an hour early and then work up to an hour earlier. Okay? And what you're doing there is you're developing a habit. It's a success habit that you're developing. So a ritual, an idea. I've experimented with many different rituals over the years, and this is the one that I do myself, but also a lot of my clients do. First thing, straight up, gym clothes on, do some exercise, 20 minutes. That wakes up the body, gets me all fired up and all those hormones moving and things moving about in your body. It's great to get you waking up. The second thing is 20 minutes of learning. So that might be reading a book, it might be watching a video. I watch a lot of inspiration or spiritual videos. Learning, that wakes up the mind. The third thing is visioning. So looking at that vision, what it is that you want, activating the law of attraction and really feeling the emotions behind it, because when you feel those emotions, that's when the magic happens. And the fourth thing that I do is I meditate. How many people in the room meditate? Fabulous. And those people that do meditate, did you notice a shift from how you were before to how you are now? Hands up if you did, show us your hands. Those people that don't meditate, look around. Meditation isn't just for monks in hills. It's for normal people. Okay, so if you are thinking you want to step up in your life, you want to achieve great things, I highly suggest that you adopt an early morning ritual. Introducing a ritual into your day will be a game changer. But listen, don't take my word for it. Try it out for yourself. You will really see the impact of it. So, four powers. We've been through the four powers that will enable you to step up and play big in all areas of your life. So the first was healthy living. The second was the way that you think. The third is your spiritual growth. And the fourth is leading your life. Food for thought? Good. So let's do a draw. Shall we do a draw? Fabulous. Now, have we got all the sheets in that want to be in the draw? Yep. Okay, fabulous. Let me take a look here. Who wants to win? Good question. Who wants to win? Let's have a look. I'm going to shuffle these because I know that somebody will have put one on the top. That would be me. I would usually do that. Okay, right. Here we go. So this is to have a 60-minute session with me. And the winner is Velma Alford. Yay! Give me a high five. Let's have a high five right here. High five. I'll see you at the back in a few minutes. Yes. Okay. Yes! Did you hear that? So let me ask you a question. The conference is coming to a close quite soon. I know you're all sad. Look at all those sad faces. Look at them all. The conference is coming to a close. How many of you are going to go back out into the real world and just get on with day-to-day stuff? No. So who is fired up and ready to get out there and do something different? Show the world what you're really about. Woo! Fabulous. So just imagine 1 week from now, will you still have this fire in your belly? Will it still be there? Fabulous. I'm glad to hear it. So tell me, we've been through a lot of stuff this couple of days. It feels like a couple of weeks, doesn't it? Absolutely, all that learning. We've been through a lot over the last couple of days. It takes courage to go back out there, doesn't it? To go out there, to step up, to do those things that you want to do and achieve those things that you want to achieve. So what might hold you back? Fear? Of success, of failure. Two sides of the coin on that one. Fear of the unknown. Fear of making sales calls. Yeah? What about not having the accountability or the tools to keep you on track? Anyone relate to that one? It might be lack of energy, lack of time, it could be ill health, procrastination, it could be overwhelm, it could be so many different things. How many of you have got those things going through your head right now? Yeah? I want you to close your eyes for a moment. Don't worry, nobody's going to poke you, I promise. I want you to imagine 1 year from now, what will life be like if you haven't done anything? You've taken no action and you're still in the same situation. Turn to the person sat next to you and give them one word that sums that up for you. Now, can you feel the shift in energy? Okay. Let me bring you back. So do you want to be that person who is playing small? Do you want to be that person instead who is living their full potential, that has overcome their fears and has cleaned up their inner world? Who wants to play big? Woo! Do you know, I think that might be a full house. Earlier it wasn't that many. That is pretty cool. For those of you that are ready to step up and play big right now, I've got a program coming up and I would love for you to join us. It's going to be fabulous. On the program, we're going to shine a light on where you're playing small in your life. And we're going to look at how to step up and play big in all aspects of your life. Every single moment in your life, so you can play big. It's a 4-week. It'd help if I press the right button, wouldn't it? Yes, Gina. There we go. So it's a 4-week online advanced training video series. What we'll do is we'll take a deep dive onto what is going on for you at the moment. And I'll give you loads of strategies so you can overcome those things and really pull yourself up to play a much bigger game. In week one, we're going to look at healthy living. You'll see a theme here. In week two, we're going to look at the way that you think. In week three, we're going to look at your spiritual growth. And in week four, we'll look at leading your life. So throughout the whole thing, you're going to get full access to that 4-week program. Now, who likes bonuses? Wait. There's not enough people saying yes there. Who likes bonuses? There we go. So this is what I've got for you. 4 live question and answer calls with me. 60 minutes, 1 a week, where you can ask any question that you may have on the topic that we're covering that week. How does that sound? That's pretty awesome. And I always look forward to doing that. The second thing is a guided workbook. So I'm going to give you a workbook where you can take yourself through all those activities that you will see throughout the program. Really thought-provoking stuff. Taking you back to those questions that I asked you earlier, that's the kind of stuff I'm talking about. And the third bonus is you will get a copy of my best-selling ebook, How to Beat the Biscuit Tin Blues. You might know it as the cookie jar. Make sense? Now, I've got 4 copies, hard copies, with me today. So the first 4 to sign up will get a signed copy of the hard copy. Okay? Thank you. At this point, some people want to know the details. How many of you are detailed people? I know you're in the house. So this is the detail that you're looking for. The videos become available from Friday the 23rd of October. And the live calls will be on a Tuesday, starting from Tuesday the 27th of October, 7 a.m. Eastern. The reason we do it at that time is to really get you up and ready for your day ahead. If we did it later on in the day, things would just kind of wean off. You might not make the calls. So we do it nice and early to get you fired up for the day ahead. How does that sound? So all in, the full program value is $1,200. You see what I did there? $1,200? We don't say that in the UK. I'm doing this really good. So $1,200. Now here's the deal, okay? For you today, if you sign up, you'll get all of this for $297. How does that sound? Thank you. As I said, it would be a real pleasure to welcome you to that program. If you want this, and if you no longer want to be playing small and holding yourself back, then step up. Make that decision, be courageous, and head to the back of the room. Get yourself signed up today, and I look forward to speaking to you in a few weeks' time to start your transformation. I'll also be at the back of the room in just a few moments' time, so please do come over, reach out, and say hello. I love my photo taken just as much as you guys do. The hard copy, yes. I've got one here with me right now. They should come now if they want that, yes. So let me leave you with my one last thought. You don't have to live at average. You were brought here to be world class. Would you agree? So make it your mission to be outstanding in everything that you do in your business and in your life. Thank you very much.
Let's give it up for Gina Battye, all the way from the UK. Gina Battye.